Hello and welcome to today's tutorial on RS2. In the tutorial, we're going to show you how to perform a coupled analysis of a road embankment with loading from typical daily traffic. Rather than focusing on building the model, though, you'll instead be working with a pre-built model of an embankment built in stages. Looking at this embankment, you'll learn about analyzing excess pore pressure, settlement, and you'll get to see the many different analysis tools that are included in RS2's interpret program. So, if you're ready to get started, open up your RS2 program and follow along. We'll begin the tutorial by opening up the starting file. To do so, go to File, Recent Folders, and then the Tutorials folder. Then select the Embankment Consolidation Initial file and click Open. You'll notice with this file, all aspects of the model have already been defined. If we click on the Project Settings icon in the toolbar, we can see the analysis settings have been set to Plane Strain, and the Consolidation option has been set to Coupled. The Coupled Analysis option is one of many offered in RS2, including Uncoupled and None. The default option when you start a new project is None. If you select Uncoupled option, this analysis type improves the stability and speed of the consolidation analyses. The Coupled Analysis option, which we're using, is for time-dependent consolidation analysis problems. Speaking of which, now let's look at the Stages tab. The Stages tab lets you set the number of stages for your model, as well as other details like the time of the stage. This feature is particularly useful for today's example, as we'll be analyzing the behavior of the embankment over the course of several weeks. Finally, let's now take a quick look at the Groundwater tab. This tab allows you to specify how pore water pressure will be modeled if you're including pore pressure in the stress analysis. There are three options available: static water, steady state, or transient. Transient is the option selected for today's model. If you'd like to learn more about any of these other options, you can check out RS2's online help section. Beyond the project settings, you'll notice that other aspects of the model have already been defined. This includes the boundaries, materials, and properties. The materials have been assigned to the model, and the embankment lifts have been filled in stages. The model has been meshed, and the water table was modeled at the depth of the lowest point of the embankment. Finally, a uniform load was applied in stages to simulate the presence of traffic on the embankment. All of this has been done so this tutorial can instead focus on analyzing the results of the model using the RS2 interpret program. To get started with that, we first need to compute the model. To do that, click on the Compute icon in the toolbar, or you can go to the Analysis menu and select Compute. Computing the model should take a few minutes. Once the model has computed, we can launch the Interpret program by selecting Analysis and then Interpret, or we can click on the Interpret icon in the toolbar. The RS2 Interpret program is the post-processing module for visualizing and interpreting the results of your finite element analysis. One of the primary means of interpreting data is by viewing the contours of different data types directly on the model. For this example, we'll start by looking at pressure head. To do so, go to the Results drop-down menu and select Seepage, then Pressure Head. You'll notice a legend is present on the left side of each view. This legend is automatically adjusted to the values at each stage of the embankment. Now, go to the View menu and select Contour Options. This Contour Options dialog provides you with a wide variety of options for customizing the way contours are displayed on the model. To have a uniform contour range for all stages, we're going to select Auto Range, All Stages. Next, turn on the Label Contour icon in the toolbar, and then click on a contour. This option shows the contour value of a selected point. You can click Escape to turn the selection mode off. Now, flip through the stages and watch what happens to the water table as the embankment is constructed and traffic loads are added. You'll notice the water table is highlighted by a pink line superimposed on the contours. As we flip to stage 5, we can see the embankment installation is completed here and the traffic load has been applied. Then, as we flip through to stage 8, you can see very little change occurs in the pressure head between the last few stages. Next, let's take a look at the excess pore pressure caused by the construction of the embankment. To view the excess pore pressure, we'll need to first set the in-situ conditions, defined in stage 1 as the reference stage. You can do this by right-clicking on any stage tab at the bottom of the screen and selecting Stage Settings. Drag the reference stage indicator to the right until Not Used changes to Initial. By making the initial stage the reference stage, the solid results of all other stages will be calculated with respect to the solid results of this selected reference stage. Now click OK to close the dialog. Once again, go to the seepage menu and this time select Excess Pore Pressure. As you click through the stages, you'll notice the excess pore water pressure builds up under the embankment and then dissipates over time. The maximum excess pore pressure in the bottom soil layers under the embankment decreases from near 40 kPa to less than 10 after stage 5. As you near the final few stages, you'll see that not much change occurs between the last few stages after the installation of the embankment is complete and the traffic load is added. If you'd like to view the profile of the excess pore pressure underneath the embankment decreasing with time, we can add a vertical material query line from the bottom of the embankment to the bottom of the external boundary. The Add Material Query option is a feature that allows you to define a query anywhere on the model and obtain data anywhere within the rock or soil mass. The data generated by the query will correspond to the contour data which is currently being viewed and can be graphed or copied to a clipboard. The query can consist of a single point, a single line segment, or an arbitrary polyline with any number of line segments. As mentioned, in this example, we'll add a query line. To add a material query, go to the Query menu and select Add Material Query. Enter coordinates 65, negative 10 as the first point, and 65, negative 40 as the second point. Press Enter to complete the selection. In the Specific Query Location dialog, enter a value of 30 in the Edit box. Uncheck the Show Queried Values checkbox and then select OK. You should now be able to see the profile of excess pore pressure underneath the embankment decreasing with time. Another aspect you can view in your embankment analysis is the settlement of the embankment. To view the settlement with the same stage settings, go to the Solid Displacement menu and select Vertical Displacement. Now, go back to the Contour Options dialog from before and change Hot to Cold to Hot. Stage 2 is the point that the first lift is constructed for the embankment. Here, you'll notice the settlement occurring below the lift. Once again, we'll click through the stages to see the change in settlement as the embankment is constructed and traffic loads are added. In addition to settlement, you can also choose to see the deformed shape. To do so, go to the View menu and select Display Options. The Display Options dialog contains a variety of options for displaying information on the model and customizing how and what analysis results are shown. In the Interpret program, the display options are organized into several categories including stress, boundaries, support, groundwater, decimals, and general. For deformed contours, we'll go to the Stress tab, and under Deformations, check the box for Deformed Contours. The Deform Contours option deforms the contour plotting on the model by magnifying the displacement at all nodes by the scale factor in the Display Options dialog. Now, we'll turn off Deformed Contour option and move on to graphing the data. Using the same material query we did before, let's plot the settlement below the embankment. Right-click on the query line and select Graph Data to graph the settlement results for all the stages. A legend on the right indicates the color for each stage plotted in the graph. On the graph, you can see the settlement of each stage plotted. In this scenario, you'll note how the vertical settlement under the embankment increases until stage 5, when the embankment is complete and the addition of traffic loads is added. After this stage, you can see the settlement stays constant for the remaining stages.
And that concludes today's tutorial on RS2. We hope you learned some useful skills for analyzing your own geotechnical projects. If you'd like to see more videos like this, you can check out our many playlists on the Rocscience YouTube channel. And while you're there, make sure you subscribe and follow us on social media to get the latest updates. All the links can be found in the description down below.